What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I am FredEFuego, flaming hot entertainment, multi-plat game trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer, bringing you old school gamer session one. This is one of my new video formats for my channel, and this is done using the playroom. It's got an old school like Serpia type filter on it where the screen looks old, and then I put some, what you see right up here, the lights. I have my real studio lights in the background giving me real light. Those give it an effect as in, you know, I'm in a in a studio. And then I have above me, we the people are pissed off. I'll get a new banner every week. It'll be a new banner. Then I have the gone full retard achievement from the Xbox One. It's like a spoof achievement. And then you have the PlayStation trophies over here. I'll get a spoof PlayStation trophy next time, and then I'll get a real Xbox trophy. I mean, achievement over here on the left next time, and then a new banner every week. Maybe I'll design some stuff, and then at the end of the video, you'll see comments roll by, you know, people making comments on videos and stuff like that. I get it from, it's called the community section in your channel. When you're doing like, you go to your video, my videos or whatever, there's a section when you're editing all that stuff. It's called the community section. And then I can get, you know, comments and stuff like that from you, the viewer, from other videos and past videos and stuff like that. So make sure you go check out my last four videos. Links will be in the description, so go check that out. Follow me on Twitter, Google+. Links will also be in the description. And any other links that you may need from my affiliates to members of Multiplat Game Trap and stuff like that also will be in the description, so go check it out. If you like this format, if you want to see more videos like it, remember to hit that thumbs up button or thumbs down, and leave me a comment, you know what I'm saying? Suggestions, stuff like that. I'm actually doing that now. I want to actually get a better rapport with my community and the viewer. So make sure you leave all that. As you can see, I have my Astro gaming headsets on, and that's what I'm recording my voice on. Using my Elgato to capture my PS4 via the Playroom so I can get this effect. It's actually going to be the lip syncing is, I mean, the audio and the syncing is not going to be. You're going to have something over there. You got Box Day in the UK, I believe it's called. It's like after Christmas where they put everything on sale. The stores put everything on sale. They have a big, you know, fire sale. So over here in the US, we have Black Friday. Black Friday is the day after Thanksgiving where everybody gets all the deals and they put everything, all their inventory gets loaded, dropped in price, and they try to sell everything they can so they could, you know, buy more inventories and go on to the next season of selling to consumers. Now, make sure that you maximize your spending for, maximize what you're buying and spend at least amount as possible so you don't go, so you get everything you want. You don't feel have buyer's remorse or feel broke at the end of that, you know, shopping season. So make sure you check up on Amazon, eBay, Yahoo, Google, Bing, all that stuff. Make sure you find all the best deals. And if I know of any deals, I will also be tweeting them to my Twitter at FredEFlame, FredEFlame, uppercase F, uppercase E, uppercase F. Link will be in the description for that. So if you don't want to look, maybe you could just go check out my Twitter once in a while, and then I have the best deals from Amazon to whatever, from Target, Best Buy, Walmart, Kmart, Sam's Club, Costco, BJ's, whatever I could actually find over the internet, I will start tweeting all the best deals that you could possibly find in electronics and gaming and music and everything. So make sure you do all that stuff. We're already 6 minutes into the video. So I wanted to talk to you about a great feature that was added to the PlayStation 4 via the firmware 2.0 update, and it's called SharePlay. I've had an extensive amount of time using it on both ends, being the person that's being the game shared to and the person doing the sharing to the game. All right. It's as easy as starting up a party chat, getting your game, starting it up, go back to the party chat, start the share play feature. Then the person that wants to actually play it, whoever's in the party chat, it'll actually give you a notification, hit the PlayStation button. Whoever wants to play the game hits the PlayStation button and then connects to it. The person sharing the game will give the controller over to the person if they want to, or the person could actually just watch them playing. Like if you're watching the Ustream or a Twitch stream via the live at PlayStation section, but it'd be directly to one PS4 to another PS4. It's basically remote play on the PS4 from one PS4 to the next PS4. And then it's used via the party chat. So that is the best, hands down, the best next-gen feature on the PlayStation 4. Not the games, not the console itself. That feature alone makes playing games more enjoyable with friends. Because a lot of friends can't buy or can't afford to buy the same game, you know, or, you know, they have a lot of different friends and stuff like that. So it gives you that feature that, you know, that we're missing, that old sit on the couch and play with me feature that we don't have anymore. You know, people don't come over to each other's houses and play games no more, especially when you're as old as we are and we have kids and stuff like that. Maybe our kids might do that, but us as adults, as parents, we don't have the time to actually go and do, you know, local co-op gameplay or, you know, multiplayer or stuff like that. So that's what it does. It gives us that type of thing. So if the game has local co-op, it give you, you can hand over the controller to the person and play local co-op, or you can hand it over to the person, you know, on the other end of the share play and let them play the multiplayer, let them play the single player. But there's a game that I bought that's the only game that I know of right now that doesn't support the feature, and that's Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I don't know if Call of Duty Ghost puts this feature in it, but Activision said they decided to turn off the feature due to the fact that they're not interested in it. They don't, basically, read between the lines, they don't really care about their consumer, their customer. They care more about their bottom line, and it's going to affect their bottom line, which I think is counterproductive, because if you let somebody that wasn't going to buy it play it via share play, more than likely, they might buy it. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's counterproductive. But anyways, if any of y'all have Call of Duty Ghost, make sure to check out if it has share play feature activated on the, you know, for the PS4, and then get back to me in the comment section, because I would definitely like to know. I've share played everything, and I've actually share played from, I live in New Jersey, all the way to California. That's 3,000 miles. And you share play with Work Birdie, and it worked perfectly. So I had no big, you know what I'm saying? And then share play, actually, if you know what it means, it's basically letting you know, one console become tangent to the other one and just working together as one console. But what it really needs is a good internet connection, especially on the person that's share playing with the other person. Speed for the person, the guest, to visually see a good picture. It's 720p, 30 frames a second. So games that are not 60 frames a second, like Destiny, Assassin's Creed, Watch Dogs, UFC, Drive Club. You know what I'm saying? Infamous Second Son. Those games are not going to be really affected when it comes to the frame rate, because it's going to be the same frame rate. But the resolution is going to be affected, and a slight downgrade in graphics. It's not going to look as crisp, as sharp, and stuff like that. But you still get an enjoyable experience. It would be more on the lines of if you play PlayStation Now, but actually better, because PlayStation Now is PS3 games when this would be PS4 games. So, in general, it's just a good experience. It's a good feature to have. It's a good option to have in your console's feature set. Now, saying that, I know the Xbox One is going to be at a super discounted price. They're actually giving away two games, a free $50 Xbox Live credit, and the console is $349. So you give that $50, and it comes, well, $329. You take off that $50, and that $50, it makes the console $280. And then two games, you take off the two games. If you were to pay full price for the two games, you're talking about, $170. You're paying for the console. So you add all that together. Xbox One has a great offering this holiday season for gamers that are interested in buying the Xbox One. And make sure that when you're doing, and it doesn't come with the Kinect, especially that version of the console doesn't come with the Kinect. But when you're looking at consoles to buy this holiday season, make sure you find out what console has the best performance, the games that you want, the exclusive games that you want, the features that you want. Of course, where you might have friends on that are playing with you that you want to play with. And then, of course, what you prefer yourself. Weigh those options out, buy what you like, and try not to have buyer's remorse this holiday season, because when it comes down to it, that's what it's all about. Buying what you makes you happy, buying what you think is worth it to you. So game how you want to game on what you want to game on, but game on. You know what I'm saying? Get gaming. That's the motto. So you got to get gaming. Game on whatever you want to game on. If you're going to buy the Ouya, you're going to buy, the Nvidia Shield. You're going to buy a gaming rig. You're going to buy an Apple computer. You're going to make your own custom rig and make a Hackintosh, or just make put Windows on it, or Linux, or put Steam OS on it. You know what I'm saying? Do what you want to do. Make sure that you are very informed on all the decisions you do for your, for your hobby, your sport, because now electronic gaming, or gaming in general, on consoles and stuff, is a recognized sport from the United States government to colleges to the sports, academia and all that stuff. It is an acknowledged sport nowadays. So you can make this a future for yourself. And there's a lot of good gamers out there that are very young. A lot of good gamers out there that are very old. All I know is I have a whole bunch of games that I've been playing. SharePlay has been a lot of things that I've actually been doing and enjoying. Being in the party chat using SharePlay is a feature that I've been enjoying extensively for the last 2-3 weeks. I got the wife got me Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I like the game. Is it my cup of tea? No, it isn't. I'm not really too into it. I haven't put too much time into it. I'm probably like a level 28 or something like that on multiplayer. But I'm about halfway through the campaign. I'm playing Drive Club. I even play Killzone Shadowfall still. They're still supporting that game. Guerrilla Games is doing a great job still supporting that game. Got some updates and stuff for the game that's been patched that makes the game run very good on the multiplayer. Gives it a lot of better frame rate. I wish Digital Foundry would do a new frame rate test on for that game. Also been playing a lot of De you know what I'm saying, still playing Destiny, not a lot of it, but still playing Destiny, waiting for that new expansion pack to come out. Haven't been playing a lot of Watch Dogs ever since I beat the game. Maybe I'll go on there, play some multiplayer, Assassin's Creed Black Flag, same thing. Need for Speed Rivals, that is bottom of the barrel for me. Infamous Second Son, beat it twice, on the good and the evil side, and then 100%ed it. Got my first platinum on that joint. UFC, I play it once in a while, still like that game. But I'm not too much of a sports, gamer or sports lover. Anyways, man, tell me what you've been playing, what you've been playing on. You have any suggestions for the show? If you want to see any of your comments in the last part of this video, make sure that you drop me a comment in any of my videos, and I'll go into my community section and it shows all the latest comments. I'll take a screenshot of them and put them at the end of my videos where I'm like this, where they're not gameplay videos. And that's pretty much it, man. I've been your host, your commentator, Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, Multiplat Game Trap, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. This has been Old School Gamer Session 1. Make sure you check out the next episode. I will be putting out these episodes every Wednesday, around 9 Eastern Standard Time. So go check out those videos. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe. If you want to follow me on Twitter, it's at FreddyFlame. Link will be in the description. Add me on, what is it, Google Plus. Link will be in the description. And all the other links will also be in the description. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get the gaming.